Hello and welcome to another edition of Local Yokel. And something seems funny here, ha ha ha. But a nice paint job on that car for sure. And if you put money in the kettle, it can do some amazing things. So the Q line is in action here along Woodward Avenue. Detroit, it's big to do. Our next big event is the NFL draft. I keep saying we need to promote more events. I mean, this is nice, but we could do all number of things. Hey, this group here is for peace. Peace and equality, yes. Well, this is a menorah in the D. It's a celebration here. I'll get around back to that. That's the city of Detroit flag, the U.S., and I think the state of Michigan. This is a kid-friendly and a dog-friendly event, family-friendly. They have butternut squash. That seems interesting. I don't know if that's tradition or what. I've never had it. Probably should have tried it. The celebration is about to begin shortly, and they'll light the menorah. They'll have some people speaking beforehand, so we'll get some of that info also. But the crowd has gathered.
Detroit. I count her as one of my friends, and I look forward to seeing her grow her influence on the directions of our city. Wink, wink. Menorah in the D, when we announced that we just purchased a home in Midtown and officially opened the doors to the public. In the past 10 years, we have seen so much change, so much growth, yet the fundamentals remain the same. The Jewish people are committed to the city of Detroit. And Detroit is committed to the Jewish people. DeVore and I are very much appreciated. I thank you for coming tonight to join us in celebration of light over darkness.
Hello, everybody.
Do you see the menorah from here?
Is it just me, or do we think an honor is serving as the highest ranking Jewish state official in Michigan history? This evening, I'd like to take this opportunity to celebrate our shared heritage and commemorate the resilience of the Jewish community through our in fear. We will not relent and we will not leave. This is our home and we have a thing to you. If you see something, if you're frightened, if you're scared, please report it to us at the Michigan Department of Attorney General, because you have Attorney General that cares about you. Woo! Community. Sam, we miss you. We will never forget you, and your memory will always be a blessing to all of us.
Israel, to serve and protect his brothers and sisters. Years under his belt of education have witnessed a deep darkness of misguided emotions and outbursts of hate. You know, equal and opposites are spark of lights of love.
They kind of passed the torch, but they're announcing the lamplighters. And this is all new to me. This is the first year I've checked this out. But wanted to see how they work this. But yeah, it's like eight lights or 8 days the oil lamp stayed lit. There's a whole story behind it. So rather than me try to explain it, just go online and check it out. I should have done the total research, but it's 8 days or whatever, but there's eight lights and there's a light in the middle. The RT-3394 will lift several people up on the lift to light the menorah, and I think they do one light at a time, but the middle light is also lit. But here they're going to get on the lift. I think this is Mary Sheffield, part of the Detroit City Council. And yeah, they're going to fire this thing up and then do a little lighting.
That's Amy. Who's that, Amy?
Hello.
There we go.
It took a few cranks, but thankfully they got it fired up, and they'll be able to lift this up so they can light it. Otherwise, I don't know what they would have done. Everybody would have stand on people's shoulders or whatever, Cirque du Soleil style. But yeah, no, they got it. Here we go. Get kind of like a propane torch lighter thing there and put it on an extend rod. So around 6:30, I'll remember for next year. The presentation started at 5, but it's somewhat with all the ceremonial stuff and speeches and whatnot. Yeah, it was a little bit delayed. Well, not delayed. They figure on this, but 6:30, so you know, and I'll try to remember. It's not exactly at sundown, but yeah, pet friendly for sure, kid friendly, family friendly, and horse friendly, or pet friendly if you have a pet horse. Okay, and then so the middle one and then the far right one. So each day I'm guessing until the end they'll have the eight or nine things lit, which will be kind of like the Catholics, the Advent calendar or the Advent wreath. There's four candles, something like that, I guess. Nothing left but the dancing. This is a 68 Camaro, but I had one with a black vinyl top like that. This was butternut yellow. I had a bright yellow, but still a nice car. And the lift was still up there. I don't know if they were ever going to plan on letting them down or what. Okay, at 6:41, they decided they'd let him down. So, yeah, the middle light and then the far one, I guess. And the one in the middle looks like it's ready to, it needs some more oil or whatever. And I'm not sure if they extinguish it in the morning and then start again and have a lighting ceremony each and every day until they get the 8 days. Oh, your guess is as good as mine. I should have done my research or asked more questions, but I like the festive atmosphere with it and all that, so that was fun. This is a fairly new bar on the corner, as far as I know, and I think a restaurant also. But I'll have to check that out. But I'm going to go into the Grand Trunk. Ooh, tonight's the night I fight Santa Claus? Wow. Pretty intense. All right. So they had a basketball game, but Detroit's going to play a game, yeah, against San Jose later in the evening. But on the second level, here's looking down. They had a good crowd here tonight at the Grand Trunk Railroad Restaurant and Pub. And they have a sign-in board over here so you can put your sticker up. Oh, celebrate diversity. Oh, no. They allow rainbow people in here, apparently. Detroit. You love Detroit. And, wow, look at this. Motor Capital must have been here at one time. Wow, wee kazowie. But, yeah, a lot of people signed in. And, nice place. They have good lighting, a good ceiling. I didn't try any of the food. I know the drinks are okay. And, yeah, this is right on Woodward Avenue. So, yeah, it's kind of a festive atmosphere. Yeah, the green light was on. And it didn't start out good here. It did start out good. 1-0. I was thinking there's another game here that they didn't do so well. Werner's Ginger Ale. I like those old signs. That's a classic. Okay, so the light's burning good, but the one in the middle looks like it's extinguished. I don't know if that's by design, if that's the way it's supposed to work. Maybe. Ice skating seems super duper popular. I should have gotten the prices for how much the rental skates are, but you could bring your own. Yeah, there's some young whippersnappers doing their thing. There should be a speed limit, but yeah, just go your own pace. But yeah, nice evening downtown on a Thursday night. You wouldn't figure so many people, but they had a function at the junction, so that helped. Man, I had to change the battery packs, but I always go to the time.is, and I can update right dead nuts accurate time to the split second. Here's a nice restaurant, their salad bar. So yeah, I just did the time and look at that. We're like dead nuts here. Within a hair, a whisker. But Woodward Avenue, Main Street, Detroit. And they have a nice bakery over here, Avalon. And they pay a livable wage and they have benefits there. Go figure. You know, so they treat their employees okay, which is what you need to do. They need to do more of that. All right, the Hudson site. That's coming along rather nicely. And this is like all like urban planning. I like to kind of go under the cover or the umbrella of urban planning. And it bores a lot of people to tears, I'm sure. But urban planning is definitely important. If we do it right, it improves the quality of life for everybody. Yes, indeedy, everybody. And so, yeah, well, Detroit fell on hard times, but man, I can just feel it every time I go downtown now. There's a nice little vibe going on. The younger kids aren't freaked out as much as my generation was that, ooh, Detroit is scary. Look at this. And then they got a back room behind these chains. It's like a secret hiding room. But it's been exposed. Yeah, so if you have a party of 4 or 5, you can go back there and hide out. This is right at Grand River. And On the upper level, this is where the music goes down. Yeah, that's how we did it back in the day. We did the vinyl thing. I don't know if those young whippersnappers know about that vinyl so much. They listen to their music on their phones and whatnot. Cafe de Mongo's, this is a nice hangout. They weren't open on Thursday night, though, so it might just be Friday and Saturday. This, I think, is the only downtown synagogue in Detroit, and it might only be the only synagogue in the city proper. A lot of the Jewish people moved up to Oak Park, Southfield, Birmingham, Bloomfield. The gentleman that was running the MC was saying, yeah, Oakland County has the largest concentration of Jewish people, but they had their presence in Detroit at one time, and now I think they want to be more a part of Detroit, which is good. There's room for everybody to promote the city, bring it back up to the stature in the heydays, I guess, that we had like in the 50s. Geez, in the early 60s, we almost got awarded the Olympic Games. We were that much on our game, but Mexico City kind of did a little underhanded thing, and they beat us out for the 68 Olympics, but well, that's history now. Sexy is calling. Look at this. Will you pick up? Well, sure will. Gosh, you can call early and often and as many times as you want. Well, coming soon, so we're going to have to wait a little bit. But across the way is Beacon Park, and they were bringing people here. Oh, rainbow people, apparently. Crap. You got to worry about that if you're in Detroit, here and there. I'm just kidding. But, people are pretty live and let live in Detroit. Do your thing. I like to, I'm going to try to promote the expression. Well, a lot of you have that sign open for business for establishments that want to make money and so forth. But the city of Detroit could use the tagline, maybe, open for pleasure. Yeah, just bring them by the busload. Yeah, love. Well, here's self-parking. I love this because if they maybe more people would park here if they just put free. But yeah, it's free, which you gotta love. That's right up my alley. Because less money that I spend for incidentals like parking and nonsense like that, the more I can spend on things like drinking and eating and frolicking around. Little Caesars Arena, looks like they allow rainbow people there too. What are they thinking? Oh my Lord. All right, another bridge update. But yeah, that was an interesting night. I enjoyed the Hanukkah celebration, although we need to try to bring a peaceful resolution because, yeah, that whole fighting thing is just beyond my pay grade. I don't understand all that. And one first step that maybe the Palestinian people could do is say, like, Hamas doesn't represent us. They're just like a terrorist organization, and I can't figure out what their goal or purpose is. We need an independent group to come in there. Get some progressive Jewish people and some progressive Arabic people, and we could get people from Dearborn meeting people from Southfield and just have a few drinks or what? Well, not drinks. You could break bread kind of thing and then discuss this because, yeah, Hamas is not right. That's we all can agree on that, but oh, my gosh. Okay, 4-4. I guess the Wings were up 4-0 at one point. And so I was kind of keeping tabs on it. I saw it when it was 1-0, and then I lost track. Nemo's, where I'm at now, I wanted to get a game update. Plus, I love the inside of this place. But the Wings scored here later in the third period with 6 minutes 40 seconds. And looking at the standings, we're in third place in our division. So we're in the playoffs as it stands now. And then San Jose did the empty net thing, and then they scored. So, yeah, tie ball game. And then, it went to overtime, and it was not a happy result. At least not for Red Wing fans. Here's Denny McClain. I remember that back in 1968. We were world champions. I was 8 years old. And, yeah, when you're 8 years old, that's like prime time for following baseball and everything. I was hooked. I listened to, like, all the games on the radio, Ernie Harwell and all that. Here was the schedule, and there were 10 teams in the American League and 10 in the National. And if you won the pennant or the thing, you went right to the World Series. Back then, Washington was in the American League. You got Boston, Chicago. Let's see, the All-Star game was in Houston. They had a Hall of Fame game in Cooperstown on the 22nd. And let's see, what else was interesting? California was the modern-day L.A., I guess. They had doubleheaders. Look on the bottom, DH. And then twi-night doubleheaders, those were cool. And it was 2 for the price of 1 back then. Now when they have a rainout or have to do a doubleheader, they want to kick you all out and charge again. It's all about the Benjamins, folks. All right. Corktown aglow. I missed this. Or wait a second. When did I do this? Okay, then we're calling it a night. Exit 202. And football-inspired bridges, but I'm going to go north to the bedroom community of Dearborn Heights. All right, so 277 now, but I think they got 10% there, but they do have tasty burgers. But just up the street from there, look at this, 275. So the ringleader went 2 cents under. I'll give you an update, too. It'd be nice to get a competition between these two Citco, so the east side and west side of Dearborn can get a good deal on gas. All right, so nothing left to do but turn the lights on. That's an Only in Detroit event, the Dirty Show, which is fun. All right, Aldi. Here's an Aldi update. This is urban planning, too, but right down to your kitchen table kind of urban planning. They now have a self-checkout, and I clip my $5 off coupon. I have $30 minimum purchase, and that's not hard to do these days, but I love Aldi, so they're open. So, yes, have at it. That's my go-to place. I can be in and out real quick. I know where everything is. All right, so the heart of this show is going to be a fashion show, and I got wind of this from Metro Times. Man, are they good with telling you the cool, hip, kind of fun events, things that are happening in Detroit. And a lot of it's for the younger crowd and whatnot. They have a lot of energy and they want to go out and do things. And but I've always liked the Metro Times, and I can always find something interesting in their magazine. And now you don't have to pick one up because it's hard to pick up a paper copy nowadays. That's old school. But you can go online and sign up, and they'll send you the emails. And we're going to check out this fashion show. And quite the entrance here with a couple of models. And then they got the runway set up. I couldn't believe all this. They had food. Look at this spread. And I asked them at the desk when I checked in because they wanted you to RSVP. So I did, but the lady wasn't in town or whatever. So I just walked up to the counter and I says, well, is there an admission price? And they said, no, you can make a donation. So I made a cursory donation of $10, but I would have done 20. I'm kind of cheap. I probably wouldn't have gone past the 20, but they had food, though, and they had music. They were doing this up. This was professionally done, and they had organizers. We're going to watch the fashion show, and this is a great space that they've redone. Let's listen in. This was a nice production. This was well done and planned out. It was called the Industry Club Showcase and Runway Fashion Show. So it was held December 9th, 6:30. The production started, the fashion show. But where it says New Lab at Michigan Central. And so it says, "Boy, the Who was Boys and Girls Club of Southeastern Michigan." And it says, why? It says, enjoy complimentary snacks and mocktails, plus explore industry club exhibits showcasing youth talent with an exclusive reveal of the Detroit Makers Market Spring Fashion Line. So that's, I guess, is what you're watching now. And, yeah, I was impressed. And a well-behaved, well-dressed crowd. And they were, I had my video camcorder, which is old school. It's a 2001 model, but a lot of people had their phones out. I'm sure some people have the iPhone Pro 15 that can take Hollywood-type style movies, but this is just an old-school camcorder, but you kind of get the idea of what's happening here. You even get a look at the ventilation system, the heating and cooling, the ductwork. But they had some male models. Mainly the ladies were showing off, which is cool. But my mom, I remember when I was a youngin, my mom said Detroit has good fashion style, or a good sense of style. Detroiters, she said, are well-dressed people. And yeah, we need to promote the fashion scene in Detroit. Why not? Along with the music scene, which we got in spades. We got a good art scene. And we got a good food scene. All that fun stuff. Like I say, Detroit, open for pleasure. But yeah, people like to get dressed up. So they like to go out on the town, look nice. This is camera number two. I only have one camera, so I'll try to move around a little bit here and there. This one's not bad. I get the runway, and then the main thing is at the end of the runway. But with the lighting here, the lighting is a little harsher from this side. But I'll move around and we'll get a nice view. Those are like where the VIP seats are over down that way. You'll hear the crowd hoot and holler every now and then when they like an outfit or like a presentation or whatnot. And there's diversity, certainly, because not everybody's like a thin model type. There's all diversity in all number of things. So whether you're woke or anti-woke, I don't know how that plays into it all. But you have to have an appreciation that not everybody looks like you. You know, kind of the thing. So that's what's kind of fun. If we were all the same, I think things would be real boring. So it's nice to have a little mix.
Yeah.
VIP type area, the end of the runway, and so the lighting is aimed or focused right at the stage here, so we'll get that. But I think it's always good to get it from different vantage points anyways. Looking up at the ceiling, man, I came back here in the day, the book depository, when it had a compromised roof. I got video for, I'd have to dig it out. I have no idea. But yeah, this was an abandoned building. They used to play hockey in the basement. Yeah, this place has history for sure. But back to the show. Come with a little attitude. You have to be a little sassy or have a little personality. Have some fun with it. But yeah, they're doing quite well, the models. The whole production thing with the music, the lighting. And did I mention it was free? God, I hope they keep doing this kind of stuff. I think I'm on their mailing list, so I should get an update on the next one. Keep my fingers crossed. Was a lot of beautiful people there, and so the show ran for like a half hour there, started around 6:30. And then the designers are here, the younger whippersnappers.
Dariana, Ziana, Angel, Zaria, Jordan, Micah, Rashad, Talia, Variety, Avery, and Dania. Make some noise for all of the youth designers.
How about that? The next generation of fashion designers. And I think they're from Detroit. Southeast Michigan Boys and Girls Club.
When y'all talk about black excellence, what? Okay! Y'all, from the dope apps to the car designs and the fashion show, I'm in complete awe. Tonight was absolutely
to be career, startup, and homeowner ready. I have the pleasure of being your pretty fashionable MC tonight. We want to thank Fifth Third Bank for serving as our presenting sponsors. Can we give them an amazing round of applause? And for our final closing remarks, I would like to bring back our amazing chief operator, Miss Elise.
We can continue to give you the amazing opportunities that you saw here today. So continue to have fun. You'll get a chance to continue to come in here and meet some of our youth, eat up all of this amazing food, and thank you so much for coming to our Industry Club Showcase. Have a great evening.
Oh, now it's time to dig in. Look at the food spread they had. My Lord. They had sponsors for the event. Oh, they had a nice video playing in the lobby. So I should have probably stayed and watched it. It cycle every maybe 3 minutes or so. But beautiful lobby here on the main level. You can get here by bike, too. Look at these styling bikes. They've got a little diversity in the styles. Limited time special, a peppermint cafe mocha. But they weren't open, but they have a little kitchen area or dining area here. It's a cool building. I wanted to explore all the floors, but it looked like they had security. So look at Channel 4 was out here. It was a big to-do. Yeah, and it was a great production. I was more than pleasantly surprised. This is off the hook. I'll have to check out on the Boys and Girls Club a little bit later, but that's the platform they set up. And they're, reserved for Fifth Third. This was like the VIP, the end of the runway. So you had to be somebody to be sitting in this area. But Yeah, an elevated platform. I'm taking notes on how they're doing all this because I think Dearborn could have a little fashion show too. Down where they're building that Peace Park kind of thing. Down by Moose's Pub. They had mocktails here, and they did one with cotton candy. I think they poured Sprite. I opted for another one that had, like, flowery stuff. But I told you I visited this place before, and this is how I remember it. The atrium was open. It was compromised. They had several fires. The weather was caving in. Water would get in and then seep into the basement, and then in the winter, of course, it would freeze over, and it was the craziest thing. They had some hockey games down there, just, you know, local yokels going down there and playing a game in between those concrete pillars and everything. And that went on for a little while until they found, it was unfortunate, but they found a homeless person that was dead in an elevator shaft. And after that happened, they kind of buttoned the building up. And then after that, Ford Motor bought the train station and some of the surrounding property, including the book depository. I tried a couple of those sandwiches. Look at this, even the flowers and the boss. I had a VIP. I felt like a VIP just for a couple, well, about an hour or two. But that was cool. They have some icons or things here, but they have... This is like a science deal they got going in this whole thing. Look at this. If I had gotten there earlier, I probably could have taken a tour and they probably had some of the building spaces open. But they're doing that. Well, this is like the start of the Electric Avenue kind of thing. And they're going to run to Ann Arbor, kind of have a connection. Ann Arbor, of course, with U of M and the like. But here's like a electric four-wheeler, and this is kind of futuristic looking, although it's present day, but look at the suspension system and all that. And then look at here, meet Archie and Mythos AI. So yeah, the world's first autonomous hydrographic vessel built for busy waterways. Yeah, AI. Pretty soon the robots are going to run the show. But yeah, I think there's still a place for human beings. I think we can still stick around for a bit longer. But yeah, urban planning, it's important. And Bill Ford, I went to the press conference when back in 2018, and they were all talking about Ford's vision for the future and all that. So downtown's there on the right, but just to the left or to the west of downtown, here it is. Ford Motor has to be commended for what they're doing there. That's exciting. Here was a lamp set up in quads, but yeah, that was the security desk. And then they had nice... Well, the concrete pillars I love. This was designed by Albert Kahn. And so everything he built was like a brick shit house. But it had a character, had a little style to it. But it's nice how the train station's lit up at night. Here's the book depository, the backside. I only got about 4 minutes. I'm going to take a walk back here, though. And they got this all lit up with, like, Christmas lights. And then the MC, do you kind of get that? The Michigan Central, what they did there. That's a clever logo. Off yonder, the Ambassador Bridge. But look at these displays of Christmas decorations. They had all sorts of things. Now, this is behind the train station, and looks like they dug up all the railroad tracks, and it's like that looks like it might be housing some apartments back there. Here's the Detroit River Tunnel. I was hoping a train would come through, but they're going to keep those two lines running, although the one on the left there I think is operational. But I heard good news that they might open that river tunnel for train traffic, commercial, not commercial, like citizen type traffic. Here, if you get in trouble, this is always nice to know. All you have to do is press that red button. I didn't touch it, but then there's a speakerphone there and the cameras are working. Security is good. I wanted to see if the drinking fountains worked, and they do. So, all right, they had a lot of informative stuff on the outside. Here's a QR code if you're quick. But Michigan Central is the centerpiece. So that's their website, too, MichiganCentral.com. And they might be delayed a little bit, but the book depository, that was the building we were just in. Engine of Invention, that is cool. So spring 2023, yes, they are open. There's a Bagley Mobility Hub, community engagement. This is the same kind of stuff they were doing with the bridge, too, getting the community involved. Because urban planning, it's like putting pieces of the puzzle together and you're interconnected. Yeah, look at the map here. Here's Southwest Detroit, Hubbard Farms, Mexican Town, Hubbard Richard. These are all neighborhoods. Corktown, that includes the train station. North Corktown, north of I-75, Midtown, downtown, West Riverfront. Everything's all connected. Pieces of the puzzle. So, yeah. And then they have the Southwest Greenway, which is what I'm walking along now. I'm going to have to wrap this up. I'll have about 12 or so minutes that carry over for next week's show, hopefully. But this building, and they got those funnel-type things, concrete support pillars here, but it looks like they're going to do something with that building. And then look at the backside of this building. Is this not cool? It's almost like a video game type thing, but lights going on and off. It's kind of neat. Even sound effects or something. I'm not exactly sure. But folks, thanks for watching. Happy holidays or Merry Christmas or Happy Hanukkah, Crazy Kwanzaa, whatever floats your boat kind of thing. But have fun.